So, did dinosaurs butt heads? Welcome to the Natural History of Dinosaurs. My name is Benjamin Berger. I'm a paleontologist at Utah State University, teaching in the heart of Utah's dinosaur country in Vernal. In this video, we'll look at the thick-headed dinosaurs, the Pachycephalosauridae, and investigate what evidence exists that they may have used their thick heads to ram into each other. The Pachycephalosauria are a group of bipedal dinosaurs that are restricted to the northern hemisphere, and they're common during the late Cretaceous in Canada and Montana, where their thick skull caps are easily fossilized since they're composed of thick bone and are often found as fossils. Most Pachycephalosaurian dinosaurs are known from the very end of the Cretaceous during the Campanian and Maastrichtian ages, and they lived alongside some of the big iconic dinosaurs like Tyrannosaurus rex. The origin of Pachycephalosaurian dinosaurs is still a bit of a mystery, as only a few are known from the middle to early Cretaceous. The Pachycephalosaurian dinosaurs were bipedal ornithischian herbivores with unspecialized teeth similar to what we see in Stegosaurus. Their neck was short with a broad pelvis, and their tail, strangely enough, was encased in a basket of bony tendons, which made the tail of the animal very, very stiff. And with the skull was always oriented so that the face was pointing down, so heads pointed down. Now, they never got much larger than cow-sized dinosaurs, despite being surrounded by much larger dinosaurs of the late Cretaceous. Now, the greatest controversy that surrounds these dinosaurs is what precisely did they use those thick heads for? In the 1950s, science fiction writer L. Springle DeCamp wrote a series of short stories where time travelers traveled back in time to hunt dinosaurs and other prehistoric creatures. It was in this imaginative world that head-butting dinosaurs first appeared. Scientists were, you know, a bit more speculative or skeptical over the function of these domed heads in Pachycephalosaurian dinosaurs. And they often would offer headbutting with a big caveat that it was with a lot of speculation. They didn't really know if they were headbutters or not. Then in the 1970s, there were a number of paleontologists who began to take this idea on, and they started to investigate the possibility that these thick domed skulls were used for combat, particularly in sexual display, similar to the rutting behavior observed in modern bighorn sheep. Using models and study of the skulls that had been discovered, and as well as the rest of the animal and the anatomy of the animal, the scientific world began to sort of accept this idea of headbutting in dinosaurs. Then, in 2004, Mark Goodwin and Jack Horner argued against any headbutting behavior in Pachycephalosaurian dinosaurs. They had taken a bunch of specimens and they sectioned, cut open the bony skulls, and they looked at the bone structure underneath microscopes. And they were studying the histology of the bone. And they found that bone density varied greatly depending on the age of the individual. Younger dinosaurs had thicker secondary zones of weaker spongy bone. They also refuted any sexual dimorphism that people had argued for in the thickness of known specimens of the skull, arguing that they were just differences in age. The researchers concluded that the Pachycephalosaurian dinosaurs did not use their thick skulls to butt heads. Two subsequent papers came out to defend the idea of headbutting in dinosaurs. The first was by Eric Snavely and Andrew Cox, who used finite element analysis to take the strength of the bone and attempt to model that strength of a butt in a computer. So using a finite element analysis. And they wanted to determine how much damage the bone could take with that headbutting. And they found that if the hit was to the center of the domed head, the spongy bone would actually act like a spring, and it would actually help cushion that blow. They found that the Pachycephalosaurians developed more domed heads over time, and they thought that this was likely to help protect their heads when headbutting with other members of the same species. Then in 2013, Joseph Peterson and colleagues decided to take a really good look at all these skulls to see if there was any damage to the bone that would be caused when butting heads. Their study documented hundreds of pits indicative of damage to the skull from impacts of other head-butting dinosaurs. The evidence for such rough damage was clear on many of the adult skulls, and paleontologists were once again confident that Pachycephalosaurian dinosaurs were the head-butting dinosaurs that science fiction made them out to be. All right, you should now be able to model how Pachycephalosaurians may have butted heads and the evidence for head-butting in this group of dinosaurs.